Hi, I'm Dr. Manjunath. I'm an orthopedic surgeon.
Well, when the back pain starts, it might be a mild back pain. This back pain, which is mild enough, can just go off in a day or two with some kind of home remedies. Then I think you are not supposed to bother about. Well, with a few home remedies, what all you know, you treat them and you may take rest, and in spite of that, pain does not subside. If it hampers in your day-to-day activity and waiting not more than 7 to 2 hours, the pain has not subsided, then this is an indication for you to come and seek the advice of the doctor. Well, when you come to us, then we start trying to get a clinical history of yours. We do examine, and yes, we next go to the investigative mode by any chance if you feel that you need further investigation to make a diagnosis. First, you would have tried with home remedies of rest, some kind of medication, some kind of ointment, which we may also follow. And yes, rest at the moment, initially is a must for you to allow the muscle which has gone in for a spasm to relax. So rest is a must. When I say rest, it does not mean to say absolutely bed rest, restricted activity. Well, there are certain back pains which needs absolute bed rest, then it is required, then you have to take. Well, there are certain back pain, it's a manageable back pain, then we say restricted activity. When we say restricted activity, bending, lifting, these are the ones which we try to tell you. Then coming to the medication, we do try with some anti-inflammatory medicine and muscle relaxant. Lot of information is available in the basic investigation, like a simple x-ray. Well, when we say x-ray will try to give a lot of information about the bone, because that's the main stay for any orthopedics with these kind of a problem. Well, there are people who just skip for many reasons, either from the patient point of view or from some reason they directly go for a higher investigation, which is not worthwhile at all. Start with a basic investigation, then proceed step by step as and when required. Well, there are conditions where we have to just jump to the higher investigation in case of crisis. Then the investigation starts with an x-ray, few blood investigation based on what clinical diagnosis we make, plus or minus abdominal ultrasound, CT scan, MRI scan, nerve conduction study, which will try to tell us whether the nerve is compressed or whether the conduction of the impulses through the nerve is there or not. So that is called as nerve conduction study. And there is what we call it as isotope bone scan. This isotope bone scan is there for two or three conditions which we regularly use. It has got large indications, but routinely we do use in case of early diagnosis, or in case of if we wanted to find out whether the disease has spread to elsewhere. So this isotope scan tries to pick up the disease as early as possible at the rate of 5% or 10% of those disease, but it will only give a hint. It's not an 100% foolproof investigation. It will only hint us to say yes, there is a problem. Then we have to go to a next level to investigate based on what we wanted. Then there is another investigation called as PET scan. PET scan, these are higher level of investigation. These are commonly used in a patients with a cancer, where the cancer would have spread elsewhere, and patient would either before starting the treatment for the cancer, or sometimes we use much earlier when we diagnose the cancer at one place, then we have to find out whether it has spread elsewhere. Then we use a PET scan, make sure that it has not spread, then we start the treatment for the cancer. And later on, we try to follow up to say whether it has spread or not, to find out whether, then we may repeat a PET scan probably 1 year later, or based on the clinical assessment. When similarly, isotope bone scan can also be used in this case, but the PET scan is much, much better. And it is more useful in these cancerous patients before diagnosis, after diagnosis, for the clinical assessment.